The Air Force Reserve proudly presents Ed Hamill and Living the Dream, a musical journey through time celebrating a century of aerobatic flight. Please bring your attention to show center as Ed flies the Air Force Reserve biplane, transporting us back in time to the graceful daredevil flying of the 20s and 30s. Our journey begins as Ed pilots the Air Force Reserve biplane through barnstorming maneuvers just like the early pioneers of aviation. Traveling from city to city, these early stunt pilots shared the joy of flight as spectators of all ages watched in amazement. In 1932, Captain Claire Chenault led one of the very first military demonstration teams, the Men of the Flying Trapeze. They flew Curtis Hawk biplanes, constructed of wood, fly wires, and fabric-covered wings. Chenault later led the famous Flying Tigers early in World War II. Just like the Men of the Flying Trapeze, Ed Hamill flies his fabric-covered biplane, representing the Air Force Reserve, barnstorming his way across America, inspiring men and women to follow their dreams. The Air Force Reserve enables Ed to follow his dreams as both a civilian and a military officer serving his country. As air shows grew in popularity, so did air races and soon competitions. Competition aerobatics is structured, consisting of flying sequences that each pilot flies for judges on the ground. Each sequence starts with three wing wags as the pilot dives into the box. Let's watch Ed dive his Air Force Reserve biplane to the show center. In April of 1948, the Air Force Reserve was formed and international aerobatic competitions were in full swing. With rules set and judges in place, competitors had to stay inside a 3,300-foot squared aerobatic box. Competition flying is more technical than barnstorming. Pilots are graded on maneuvers like point rolls and vertical lines. Just like serving in the Air Force Reserve, competitive aerobatics requires discipline, dedication, and commitment. Ed has flown his Air Force Reserve biplane in many competitions, including three U.S. National Aerobatic Championships, qualifying for the 2002 U.S. Advanced Aerobatic Team. Ed's full biography can be found on his website at edhamill.com. We have arrived at the present day, 2007, and our journey has brought us to high-energy sky dancing. Combining the adventurous spirit of barnstorming with the precision of competition, Ed brings you a breathtaking aerial ballet. Just as the Wright brothers followed their dreams at Kill Devil Hill in 1903, Ed's dream is to sky dance for you. Look up and watch as Ed begins the dance. Ed was inspired by an air show to set his goals of becoming both a fighter pilot and an air show pilot. After years of hard work and never giving up, Ed now lives his dream as a full-time aerial performer and part-time Air Force Reserve mate, teaching young Air Force pilots to fly the F-16 Viper at Luke Air Force Base, Arizona. Thank you. performs maneuvers like the centrifuge, snap rolls, and outside turns. But negative G and gyroscopic forces are more physically demanding than those he experiences as an F-16 instructor pilot. Receiving education and training benefits. They use their skills to defend both their country and freedom around the world.
Modified
Air Force Reserve 5th Special.